What homework do you have left?
Just some calculus work.
I don't know if I can help you with that, not even with the extra brain.
My name is James. I am 46 years old, and I have a very large lump on my forehead. My bump is approximately the size of a golf ball. It's squishy and soft, but it has also got some density to it as well. So the bump started about 15 years ago. It was just a very small bump. At first, was kind of worried about it, but I had spoke to a doctor at a clinic, and he told me it was nothing to worry about. It was probably some fatty tissue buildup. It wouldn't be worth having removed because the scar itself would be way more noticeable than that small lump I had on my forehead. But 5-6 years ago, it tripled in size to the point it's at now. It's now worked its way down into my face and close to my eye socket. I mean, multiple times a day, you'll think I'm wiping my eye, but I'm actually just putting pressure against the lump, hoping I can keep it from going into my eye. Hi, Alexis. James over at Wholesale Outlet. About your interest in the 2012 Chevy Camaro, give me a call back when you get a moment. Just ask for James.
I am a car salesperson. I sell vehicles to people.
Pretty soon, it's going to need its own zip code.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah.
But it's all in good fun.
Yeah, right. You got most of the stuff done already?
Yeah.
When it comes to my wife, she does worry about it quite a bit. It makes me feel bad that other people are concerned about me. They shouldn't have to worry about me. They have their own problems to worry about.
I just want to make sure that whatever is going on, it's not dangerous and it's not something that's going to kill you. I don't want our kids to lose their dad. I feel like James has definitely kind of put it off and pretended like it wasn't a big deal. But if this is something that's serious, we need to find out now and not wait until there's nothing that can be done about it.
You're right, it bothers me, and it bothers me that it bothers you, and it's got to be taken care of. It's not a good feeling when somebody tells me that they're worried about me living or dying because of something that I could have had done. What if it is something that I should have had done years ago? I have to do it now. Here at Dr. Lee's office right now, I feel excited.
Dr. Lee, we'll be right with you, okay?
Thank you, I appreciate
it.
This is something that I should have had handled before, and I'm hoping Dr. Lee can help me out today, and I'm hoping that I'm gonna be able to go talk to my wife and my children and be able to say, you know what, it's gone, it's not anything for you guys to worry about, and it's not anything that's gonna harm or take me away from them.
Hello.
Hi.
Are you Mr. Adam James?
Yes,
right?
Dr.
Nice
Lee.
To meet you.
Nice to meet you.
We're out here so that we can comfortably and safely take off our masks, so you're welcome to do so as
Thank
well.
Thank you.
You got something on your head.
I do. I'm
it's
hoping
like a golf ball that's wedged in there. How long have you had that?
About 16 years.
16 years. It's about ready to drive, huh?
Yeah.
Well, how did this start?
It was a very small bump, and I only had like a wellness check, and I was told it was nothing to worry about. And
I see.
It's with things like this, other people's lives get in the way, and you just ignore yourself.
Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna take a look at it. If you don't mind putting back on your mask.
No problem.
For safety's sake, I'm gonna do the same. If there's one thing that I know as a dermatologist, or any physician in general, is that patients will procrastinate. It's always a surprise, and yet not a surprise, when I see somebody with a big growth who has not seen a doctor in years. Certainly, I'm gonna suggest that people get a growth checked out. And so, hopefully this is nothing too scary, but I'm gonna have to take a closer look. I notice what's kind of interesting about it is that, like, when you push on it, it's sort of like that memory foam. It doesn't feel like full liquid, but it is definitely soft here. But the fact that it's kind of compressible like that, you know, makes me think, is this a fluid? I see lots of cysts and lipomas on the forehead. Usually they're more bouncy, or they're more tense, or they're more rubbery. I've never felt one that feels like memory foam. And it really makes me suspicious that this might not be something that I can remove.
If it's a fluid, like a yellowish fluid or something, I would probably not continue. You know, I don't want to scare you or anything like that, but like, what if it's cerebrospinal fluid? It like coats our spinal cord and around our brain, kind of giving it a little buffer. So I think what I would probably do here first is see if I can pull or aspirate, what we call, like a little bit out.
Aspirating means taking a needle and really sucking out some of the contents from this growth to get an idea, like sort of a preview of what this might be. Is this blood? Is this fluid part of the central nervous system? Is this cerebrospinal fluid? These are things that I really feel strongly that I should not potentially proceed.
Okay, one of my girls is gonna come by and get you and bring you into the office and we'll get started, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, of course.
Thank you, Dr. Lee.
I will see you in a little bit.
Dr. Lee said that she wouldn't be able to remove it if there was fluid that came out that was not normal. It does scare me. It would be my fault that it wasn't taken care of.
So you shouldn't feel anything other than me just pushing on you here, okay?
I've really never seen a bump like this. He's had it for 16 years, and it shifts in this really strange way when I push it from side to side. So I really think the best plan of action for me is to first aspirate the contents. And if this is a lot of blood, if this is cerebral spinal fluid, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to proceed.
Let's see what comes out initially. Oh, look at that, cyst. See that little bit right there?
Oh, yeah.
We got a cyst in there. So that's good. It's not brain.
Yeah. It is such a relief to know we're moving on from here and we're gonna remove this today.
Let's see if you can squeeze it out. What do we think is inside this little friend of yours? Hold on, let me see. Yeah, a little hair's trapped in there. Keeps coming. There's more hairs in there. Yeah, maybe you could have a little dermoid cyst here. A dermoid cyst is something that you're kind of born with more so, but we'll see.
I'm squeezing out this cyst, and the first thing I notice is it's filled with hair. So it made me start to think, could it be a dermoid cyst? Dermoid cysts really develop during fetal development. A dermoid cyst can contain hair, it can contain skin, it can contain teeth or bone even. Or could this just be a cyst that has a lot of hair trapped in it because the hair grew the wrong direction into this cyst?
It just looks like mashed up banana from your drain in your bathroom. Because it's got hairs in it. You got like a whole serving for your whole family here. This is the container it's in. That sac wall is like a stronger sac wall. If I don't get all this out, then it's gonna come back. You can see here's the sac here. This could be the end of it. Yes. All right, we're stitching this one up.
I was really worried that this was gonna be something more serious, but it was a cyst. I know that James is relieved, and so am I.
Okay, you ready to see it here?
Yes. Oh, so different. As I look at myself in the mirror, I see a new person, a person that is myself.